Hello, I'm Maruk Said, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Serratia marcescens is a gram-negative bacterium from the Enterobacteriaceae family. The genus presently includes at least 20 species, 8 of which have been linked to human illnesses, with Serratia marcescens serving as the primary human pathogen. Serratia marcescens is commonly found in water, soil, and plants, and it causes a range of hospital-acquired diseases. Serratia marcescens now has a thin peptidoglycan layer, which means it does not retain the crystal violet dye during gram staining. Instead, like all other gram-negative bacteria, it stains pink with saffronin dye. And because it's a gram-negative bacillus, it appears as a little pink rod under a microscope. Serratia marcescens is motile and facultative anaerobic, which means it can live in both aerobic and anaerobic conditions. It is urease positive, which means it can manufacture urease, an enzyme that converts urea into carbon dioxide and ammonia. To test this, transfer a pure sample of bacteria from the culture to a sterile tube containing urea agar, broth, and phenol red. Next, the mixture is incubated. So, in Serratia marcescens, urease causes urea to dissociate into carbon dioxide and ammonia. Ammonia then causes the mixture to change color from orange-yellow to vivid pink. It is also catalase positive, which implies it has the ability to make catalase. To test for this, a few drops of hydrogen peroxide are applied to the suspicious bacterial colony. So, if catalase is present, it causes hydrogen peroxide to split into water and oxygen. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Furthermore, it produces another 3 enzymes, DNase, lipase, and gelatinase, which are unique to Serratia, and this can help easily differentiate it from other Enterobacteriaceae. Finally, Serratia marcescens thrives on MacConkey agar, a medium containing a pH-sensitive dye and lactose. This medium assists in determining if gram-negative bacteria are lactose fermenters or not. Some bacteria, such as Klebsiella, Enterobacter, and Escherichia coli, may digest lactose, producing acid that causes the pH-sensitive dye to become pink, resulting in pink colonies. Others, such as Salmonella, Yersinia, and Shigella, are unable to digest lactose and hence produce colorless colonies. Serratia marcescens and Citrobacter are sluggish lactose fermenters, thus they take their time but finally ferment lactose. So, at first, the colonies seem colorless, but after 48 hours, they become pink. Finally, some Serratia marcescens strains produce a distinctive red pigment called prodigiosin, which is commonly observed staining showers, toilet bowls, and wetted tiles. When incubated at 25 degrees Celsius, the production of this pigment might result in the growth of red colonies on agar. Okay, Serratia marcescens possesses very few significant virulence factors, such as fimbriae that connect to host cells and hemolysins, which produce microscopic holes in the cell membrane, resulting in cell destruction. However, it has the ability to build adherent biofilms on medical equipment, such as breathing apparatus, intravenous and urine catheters, and contacts. A biofilm is essentially a coating of slime composed of exopolysaccharides, EPS, in which Serratia live and multiply. When comparing a biofilm to strawberry jam, the seeds are the bacteria, and the remainder of the jam is the EPS. Biofilms make it harder for drugs to reach the germs, making the illness more difficult to treat. As a result, in hospitalized patients, it can induce a variety of hospital-acquired illnesses. And the danger is larger in immunocompromised people, such as those who are HIV positive or have an underlying disease like diabetes or cancer. As a result, those who are mechanically ventilated may get pneumonia. it has the potential to induce urinary tract infections, UTIs, in those who use urinary catheters. People who have a blood vessel catheter or who inject intravenous medications may get bloodstream infections, such as bacteremia or sepsis. Bacteria in the circulation may potentially reach the heart, producing endocarditis. Neurological equipment, such as a ventriculoperitoneal shunt used to redirect cerebrospinal fluid away from the brain ventricles and into the peritoneum to decrease intracranial pressure, can result in central nervous system infections such as meningitis or cerebral abscesses. People with burns or surgical wounds may develop skin and soft tissue infections such as cellulitis, fasciitis, inflammation of the connective tissue around muscles, blood vessels, and nerves, myositis, muscle inflammation, and skin abscesses. Finally, eye infections include conjunctivitis, conjunctival inflammation, and keratitis, corneal inflammation. Symptoms are often vague and vary with the kind of illness, so pneumonia can cause fever, chills, cough, and chest discomfort. A urinary tract infection can cause dysuria, which is defined as discomfort when urinating, urine frequency, or urinary urgency. Skin and soft tissue infections can cause swelling, erythema, soreness, and discomfort. A bloodstream infection may cause fever, chills, hypotension, and tachycardia, and endocarditis may result in new heart murmurs on auscultation. Meningitis and brain abscesses may cause fever, headaches, and vomiting. Skin infections will be addressed next. Cellulitis symptoms may include swelling, erythema, discomfort, and purulent discharge. Skin abscesses are associated with redness, heat, swelling, and discomfort. Fasciitis symptoms include fever, edema, and severe discomfort, whereas myositis causes muscular weakening. Finally, conjunctivitis symptoms include eye redness, pain, and burning in the eye, whereas keratitis develops with eye redness, discomfort, and photophobia, or eye pain caused by light exposure. Serratia marcescens can be recognized in a culture of blood, sputum, urine, or cerebrospinal fluid, depending on the infection. A urinalysis should be performed for UTIs, which may reveal bacteriuria, the presence of bacteria in the urine, and pyuria, the presence of white blood cells in the urine. A chest X-ray may be used to diagnose pneumonia, a brain CT scan, and a lumbar puncture to aid in the diagnosis of central nervous system infection, and echocardiography to detect endocarditis. Serratia marcescens has developed resistance to routinely used antibiotics such as ampicillin, macrolides, and first-generation cephalosporins. As a result, therapy consists of aminoglycosides combined with anti-pseudomonal beta-lactams, such as piperacillin, tazobactam, and ticarcillin, clavulanate, followed by fluoroquinolones or carbapenems if the infection continues. Abscesses should also be drained. Summary: Serratia marcescens is a gram-negative bacillus that belongs to the Enterobacteriaceae family. It is a motile, facultative anaerobic, urease, and catalase-positive, sluggish lactose fermenter that forms pink colonies on MacConkey agar. It is an opportunistic organism that causes a wide range of hospital-acquired illnesses, including pneumonia, urinary tract infections, ophthalmic and central nervous system infections, and endocarditis. Serratia infections are identified by detecting the bacteria in a culture of blood, sputum, urine, or CSF, and they are treated with aminoglycosides, anti-pseudomonal beta-lactams, fluoroquinolones, and carbapenems. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon button. Thank you!